Hi guys, and welcome back to SiteEnch. In today's video, I'm going to show you the Leica TS15 and the stakeout program. Before we go, just guys, remember to subscribe to my channel, leave some comments, as this is going to show me that you're interested in it, and then whatever I'm doing, it makes sense and there's more and more people watching it. So let's go and have a look at that stakeout. Hey guys, so after a little introduction about the stakeout, we're just now in our SiteEnch field and we're gonna stake out some points. So I'm gonna use firstly reflectorless measuring on the instrument and then just manually aiming at the point, and then we just connect with the prism and we're gonna find the point with the prism. So let's have a look. We're gonna choose some point. And we're gonna be using map for it. You don't have to use the map, of course. You can go to work, you can press stakeout, you can choose your control job, okay. And you can find wherever point you wanna stake. So that's one way of doing it. But I want you to actually learn using the map. I think we can actually stake our station 5, which we marked in the first video about the surveying. So we're gonna press ST5, we're gonna tap and hold, and we're gonna press stake point. So now you're gonna see the window showing the stakeout, and we're gonna press distance and we start looking for it. Our point is 380 millimeters from the instrument and 440 right. So I'm gonna start looking for it. I got 350 and 450 right, so I'm gonna start manually turning the EDM and we're gonna get closer. You can see now we are within 300, so the different screen showing you the target, and then we are just 8 mil and 14 mil. So that's how we find in the points, really, just wherever I just turn just randomly. Now instrument, now we know we are 3 meters. We have to go now 3 meters towards the total station and then 1.8 meter left. What you can see, you can use the different screen showing you the map, but I never used it myself. Okay, so we are now, as you can see, 3.5 meter. So we're going we're going closer to the EDM. And we find in the point, and we are 10 mil towards instrument, 10 mil left, two mil. So we are now just on the point, and that's how we're gonna be marking the points. Wherever points it's gonna be, it may be points for your drainage, it may be points for your openings in the slabs. So that's the way how we're gonna be doing. We're gonna do a quick exercise with the pole and the prism as well, and we're gonna find the point this way. So I'm just gonna put my remote and install it on the pole. What we're gonna do now, we just quickly change the prism for our Leica prism we're using right now, really. And then I just extend it a little bit. And we're gonna find our target. So we're gonna press the target option here, and we're gonna do the power surge right button. And now we're gonna press our power surge left button. So now we are connected and the instrument is locked on our target, on our prism, and we can just actually do the same exercise but using the Prism this time. We're gonna stake point SFL. So I'm gonna press and hold, and I'm gonna do stake point. I'm gonna do stake point and distance. So now the arrow is showing me how far off the point I am now, and the best way to use it is just have the EDM behind you, as it shows you how far you have to go from the EDM. So the instrument shows me 1 meter that way, arrow that way, and 1.6 meter this way. So I'm gonna be looking for it now. $50 mil and $60 mil, $25 mil this way. So as you can see now, we just need to level in the pole. It's just a bit windy today, so it's not easy to do it, but you can see on the screen I'm within 10 mil, let's say. So that's how you do it, using the prism and the pole. So that's the way really you using the stakeout, which is one of the most used options on the EDM. You just can use it using the prism, as we're probably going to be using, or you can use the EDM and just shoot directly with the EDM manually handling the station. Guys, that's it in today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and I believe you just make another step forward in your setting out site engineering knowledge. If you have any questions, if something was unclear, please let me know, leave in the comment below. And please guys, subscribe to my channel and turn the notifications on, so you're gonna know when my next video gonna be released. So thank you again for watching, and see you next time back on my channel.